Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Father, we, your children, we are gathered here tonight to praise you, to exalt you, to thank you for everything you've done in our lives. We are also asking for solutions to all our problems. Today, tonight, Father, all our deliberations are before you. Whatever we ask you, we requested, Father, come and grant it unto us. Father, we are asking for your solution. Solution to all our problems, to all our requests. Father Lord, please in your mighty, come and give us your grace tonight. As regards our problems and our everything we've got in our lives. Father, we also ask you for you to pardon us as we got our sins. Come and forgive us of all our sins.
Amen.
Because we know you are the Alpha and the Omega. Without you, we cannot get any solution to any of the problems tonight. Father Lord, we are also praying for the Pastor Olafisoye, who is going to conduct the service of tonight. Father, come and grant him your anointing, your mighty counsel, your prayer, your everything you got, so that the man of God can worship you ever and ever.
Amen.
Father Lord, we are also praying for all our members of the church who are on their way to the service. Father, please let them have a journey mercy.
Amen.
Let them come here tonight and worship your holy name and exalt you. Father, we are also asking for your forgiveness of sins, because without that, we cannot achieve whatever we requested from you tonight. Father, we thank you for everything you've done to us. We thank you for your life. We thank you for the water you've given us. Thank you for the healing. We thank you for the mercy, the grace and everything, the everlasting love. We thank you for whatever you've granted us to make sure we are still alive today. We thank you. Father, tonight, the solution night, come and grant us all our requests. And give us a solution to all our prayers unto you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Mighty name, we pray. Amen. 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 Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Shall we just close our eyes to worship God?
Now what worthy? Now what worthy? To receive glory, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Service, you have to pray with all aggression that you've never done before. You open your mouth wide and talk to your situation. We are shouting at our problems now, not only God. We are addressing your situation right now. So when people say you are shouting when you are praying to God, no. We worship God, we praise Him in all otherness with God. But right now, the revival service ready to cry. Man say to me that when you cry on your problems, then shall it come back. If you don't cry, your protest, if you stay there, I'm talking to you. We are at the time of talking about this now. Amen.
Oh God, that answered by fire. You will answer me by fire. You will answer me by fire. Oh God, that answered by fire. You will answer me by fire. You will answer me by fire. I'm going to go to the hospital.
We reverence you. You are mighty God. You are the King of Kings. You are the El Shaddai, the omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent. You are Yah that I am. We welcome you to our presence. Come and do only that only you can do. Come and do only that you can do. Come and do only that you can do. In our presence, you have. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we give thanks.
Amen.
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 Fire of God, enter my life. Enter my soul, in Jesus' name. Fire of God, enter my life. Enter my soul, in Jesus' name. Fire of God, enter my
power of the powers of darkness that they will not let you go ahead. What you want to reach your goal?
they control you. You know the cows, when they pull them, they put the wire on them, that they are being yoked together. Mm. No one will go before the other.
Yeah.
So when you want to move forward, they will control you, will pull you out with the yoke. So every yoke must die in your life.
Every yoke must die in my life!
Every yoke must die in my life!
That is your yoke!
What do they have? They have an agenda.
Every agenda of darkness.
Every agenda of darkness.
Every agenda of darkness.
Every agenda of darkness.
For my life.
For my life.
Vanish. In the name
Amen. Who is satisfied with his present position? Who is satisfied with his present position? I think there is nobody. Therefore, you cry after things like this.
Oh Lord!
Oh Lord!
Let my life!
Receive!
Divine acceleration!
Divine acceleration!
Oh Lord!
Let my life!
Amen. The dark world, when you put curses on people, they program it ahead, future dates. Therefore, pray like this in the name of heaven.
Amen.
That's what they use. They bury virtues. They bury blessings. They bury goodness of people. And they fashion campaign against people. Therefore, you pray like this. In the other way, our Lord Jesus Christ prays. Until I said,
You my Lazarus.
That is what you are expecting from your Almighty God. So you know how you cry unto him. That's what your comfort. You tell that the way Jesus Christ pray. You know Jesus Christ, you don't say, hey, you Lazarus, come. He said, cry out. Sacrifices, rituals, they do it for children of God's sake. So you don't know what they have done in that world against you. So you cry out again like this.
Every evil ritual, a sacrifice, let me give you some things against me. When they steal a righteous, they either bury it or they carry it to their second heaven. Or they put it in the waters. I won't have time to take the one from heaven, but to take it silently. Let's take the one from the waters now. I speak on the bellies of the water.
I'm going to give you praise. I want to bless us mightily, so that we shall not be the same again. In Jesus' name we pray. You can do better. Amen. Let's all sit down in God's presence. Amen. Sit down and relax. Amen. When I mean relax, I don't mean you should just cool it off. Amen. I'm just going to introduce the ministers that are in the house. The minister of God that God has just used for us, who just finished from the podium, is Pastor Yinka. Give God a round of applause, Pastor Yinka. It's an heavily loaded man of God, a product of NFL. Amen. Give it to Jesus in his life. One of the things I love in his life is a zeal and humility. Pastor Inka is 60 years, but with the way he will address everyone and the way we relate together, you will think we are friends. In fact, you'll be saying my father in the Lord, I say, don't kill me. I'm just, in fact, I'm your son. You say, by age, you say, by. So I respect the humility in him. And I thank God for his life. And with us here today, we have another minister of God who I'm meeting for the first time. I know the wife for a long time. I've known the wife now for quite a long time. I won't tell you when, since when. So that you won't be calculating that for me. Amen. We have here as well Pastor Ajibola. I want him to shout hallelujah when he said, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We also have in the house Evangelist Famino. I want her to shout hallelujah when she's seated. We also have in the house Pastor Mrs. Ajibola. Let her shout aloud hallelujah where she is at the back.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. So we just thank God for a time like this, and I appreciate you all. The next thing is that I want to welcome you to Solution Night for the month of July. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to just, as you're sitting down, think of the month of July. If you are counting months, what number does it fall on?
Seven.
And why is it that God asked us to be doing our solution night and the end of each month? I will tell you along the line. And immediately after solution night, which is this Friday, the upper Friday, we normally have something called Night of Wonders within the same time as well. I'm going to tell you the aim of this and why the Holy Spirit told me that. God wants some problems to end in your life. And that is why we're having Solution Night at the end, at the last Friday of the month. And God wants to make the good things that have begun permanent wonders in your life. That is why we have first Friday of the month. Amen. And when I was praying to God, God, what is the theme for this month's Solution Night? The theme he gave me was an answer to my prayer as well. And the theme, he said, is going to be the palace of fulfillment. Give it to Jesus. Give it to Jesus. Lord. And the Lord told this somebody something. He said, listen to this very well. He said, as many that will step into that program, before they leave, they will be fulfilled.
Amen.
The Lord said, one thing you should observe in that program is that there's going to be joy in the environment.
Amen.
And when praise and worship started today, I could see that there's joy in the environment. The Lord told me you will see some unexpected faces. While I was beating the drum, the brother just came and the Spirit of God said, that brother can play the drums. You see, he relieved me. We have more than enough instrumentalists in the house today. About two drum set players are available, two keyboard players. Everything is just a proof to me that indeed it is fulfillment.
Yeah.
I want us to pray now. I welcome you all to Solution Night, and I'm saying that by the time, in fact, in the next 30 minutes time, within 30 minutes, your story will change.
Amen.
I'm not speaking word of encouragement, but I'm speaking under the apostolic unction of God upon my life and the prophetic unction that has never failed. I'm speaking under the same unction through the grace of God that raised the dead. The same unction that opened the eyes of the blind. The same unction that has healed stroke. The same unction that has done wonders beyond my imagination. The same unction that has healed HIV. The same unction that has healed cancer. I'm speaking of reality. It's not word of appraisal. I believe nothing is impossible before God Almighty. And that is my faith in Him. And it has never failed me. As many that have the faith that there's going to be a change of story in their life, before you leave, your story will change.
Yeah.
And if you think your faith is not just enough, I just want you to plug in to the faith of the ministers of God in the house
And you are going to see that your life would be illuminated by the efficacy of the word of God tonight. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to bow down our heads in prayer. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh, let's say we should sing this song together. Let us stand up quickly. I just heard it. And I saw angels of the Lord just descending and ascending. And the song they were singing says,
He is Lord. He is Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Every knee is shall bow. Every tongue confess. Jesus shall reign forevermore. I want to launch you to doing is challenging your challengers. Praying Daniel in the den of lion is any thought that was the final they can do to him. But the lion of Judah shut the mouth of lions in the den of lion, and lions were not able to harm Daniel. Not because they were not hungry, but because the master, the king of glory, the creator of all lions was in control. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were thrown in the burning furnace. Indeed, the giant that killed them in the mighty man, the king of the fire, killed them immediately. But the fire that was supposed to kill them, because the greater fire penetrated, lo and behold, it took the power with which fire can burn Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego from fire and became a protection for them. I want you to sing this song with me. And listen, if you have not heard it or if you hear it for the first time. It says, the word I'm asking of my God. The word I'm asking of my God. Oh my God, manifest. The drummer can please kindly get on the drum. I'll sing the song and you listen for you to grab it. The one asking of my God. The one asking of my God. The one asking of my God.
I want you to pray to prayer point. After the conclusion of a revival program that I was invited to in the church, a man of God who was 60 plus in age came to me and said, "Pastor, I want you to pray for me." I said, "Sorry, I can't pray for you now." He said, "Please, with all humility, I'm not concerned about my age. Just pray for me." I said, "It is not right for me to have told you I don't want to pray for you initially. But although I don't have the time to talk on this because of things I've got to do and where I'm going, but I'll spare you the time. Sit down, everybody, and listen to this." I said to this man, "The Spirit of the Lord told me that you pastored in a place 4 years ago as an assistant pastor." He said, "Yes."